To upgrade the firmware in either the Ethernet IP or the Modbus TCP communications cards, just remove the drive keypad and the cover and locate the 3-in-1 firmware upgrade card. Different drives have it in different places, so just look for a card like this with both a USB and an RJ45 connector. This is where it is on this B-frame size drive. Before doing anything, make sure that drive power is off and your computer is not connected to the 3-in-1 card via USB. Plug the communications card that you want to upgrade into this connector on the 3-in-1 card like this. Now that everything's in place, plug the USB cable into your computer and the 3-in-1 card. The entire firmware upgrade process is powered by the USB cable, which explains why we don't want the USB cable plugged in while we insert the COM card, and why we want the drive powered off while we do this. In a GSoft application, don't try to connect to the drive. It's powered down, right? Instead, go straight to this network button. Select the COM port that your USB cable is emulating. If we go look at the Windows Device Manager, it's this guy, which on my system is this COM port. So we put that here. Firmware and software for the GS4 drives is always free to download from the AutomationDirect web store under Downloads. Once you download the latest firmware for the communications card you have, select that here. Now beware, I'm using pre-production files. The file you get may look different than this. Well, great. We selected the file and we selected the COM port. Now we just hit upgrade. That'll take a few seconds to start, and then you'll see all the packets being sent to the card. It takes about a minute, and then you see the success message. Notice that the orange LED doesn't turn off on the card until you hit exit. Be sure to hit the exit button to wrap things up. Well, that's all there is to it. Remove the USB cable to remove power from the board, then remove the board and press it firmly into slot 1. Secure with the included screws, replace the cover and the keypad, and you're good to go. Let's power up the drive and see if it worked. If we go to parameter 944, we see that we do have the Ethernet IP card. And parameter 945 shows us the firmware version. You read it by byte, so that's version 1.1, which is exactly what we expect. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn more about AutomationDirect's free support options. And click here to be notified when we publish new videos.